Amanda with Straight Smile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to be talking about the Frankel appliances, which is one of many different myofunctional appliances slash orthotropic appliances that are out there. This has been around since the World War II era, but it's still a good appliance. I'll talk about the pros and the cons. I think I've used it once. I wouldn't say it's my go-to appliance, nor do I recommend it, but it really does work. So basically the way this one works is that it harnesses the benefits of the pressure of the tongue by reducing the strength or the pressure of the cheeks and lips. So remember, we gotta go back to the beginning. Why do we have malocclusion? We have malocclusion because our jaws are underdeveloped because of an improper diet, soft foods, not, you know, eating a sandy gritty diet, not chewing meat off the bones, using pacifiers, using bottles, not breastfeeding exclusively for 2 to 3 years like they do in tribal countries, et cetera, et cetera. Our first world diet and way of life does not contribute to good occlusion. That's just how it is. So luckily we can do things about it. So what this does, and there's a variety of different iterations of this and formations of this for class 2 or class 3 bites. This one is meant for class, think about this for a second, class 2. So it's got the labia bow, which is well adapted to the front teeth here, which prevents the front teeth from moving forward, right? Prevents the class 2 from getting worse. And this acrylic pad is not touching the lower teeth. It's actually a couple millimeters away. So it acts almost like a lip bumper, which prevents the lip from pushing those teeth back if you're sucking your lip or anything like that. And the cheeks, it keeps them out of the way so that the tongue can expand the arches. And it also puts the teeth in an edge-to-edge position, which encourages the lower jaw to grow. So it's a very effective class 2 appliance. The problem is it's a one-piece appliance. It's incredibly difficult to talk with it in. It's incredibly bulky, and you can't make any facial gestures. Like, you can't, it's uncomfortable if you do. You can't smile. You basically have to be stoic. So it's not the most fun experience. You really need to try to wear it full time. For the patients that maybe are homeschooled, or you can pop it out if you need to give a presentation or something, or, but you probably need to wear it for a good 6 to 9 months, like any functional appliance, for it to work. So very young appliance, patients 7, 8, 9, they're sometimes cool to wear stuff like this to school. They think it's cool. I remember when I was in third grade, I died to have something like this. It's so cool, especially if you could pick a color of the acrylic. So, just because you don't think you'd like it as an adult, you'd be surprised 7, 8, 9-year-olds might be fine with it. And it works really, really well. Now, the opposite version, the class 3 version, or the Frankel 3, is going to be opposite. You're going to have the pad up here, allowing the tongue to be able to flare the upper incisors, and you're going to have the bow down here, not allowing the incisors to move forward. I don't know that it works as well. I would still prefer the reverse pull headgear just because there is a force, a traction being applied to the upper jaw. But I mean, it's definitely an option that's out there. So, and I think it's cost effective. It probably only costs a couple hundred dollars to wear. So you don't have to attach it to braces or anything like that. So definitely something to keep in mind, especially if cost is an issue and if you think compliance is gonna be good. And you know what? Just create a compliance contract. Basically, you're saying, hey, this is only going to work if you wear it. There's no guarantees. If you don't wear it, that's what you're going to get. You're not going to get anything worse if you just improve it 50%. It's going to be 50% better, if they're kind of half compliant. And you always finish the rest up in braces. So, for patients that are on the budget, I think you should really have this option because not everyone is going to be able to afford Invisalign with MA. That's just, the lab fee is too high, So if we can make this for a third of the lab fee and really have probably very little to no monthly office visits, they just wear it and check it. You shouldn't really have to do any adjustments on it or anything like that, or rescans. I think it's a very cost-effective way to help to improve malocclusion in kids. So don't rule it out. All right, everything old is new again, right? It still works. Thanks.